Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop video, we'll be cleaning up the background of this picture of these two rings using the pen tool and giving us that. Now, if you like this video, make sure you click that like button and also click down below there where it says share and share with your friends through social media. If you haven't already done so, make sure you subscribe as well. And to learn a lot more about using Adobe Photoshop, take a look at my complete training course and you'll find a link right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Here's the original image right down here, and then here's our cleaned up image. If you look over here on this layer, we're using a layer mask to clean out that background, just to hide that background. If I go over here and disable, there's the background, and then enable as well. Now the nice thing about the layer mask is I can come back in and I can clean it up if I need to. If I make any mistakes in here, it's easy to fix the layer mask, and we never touch the actual original image. Okay, let's see how this whole thing is done. I'm going to start from scratch. I'm just going to delete these two layers here, and we'll go right back to the first layer. First thing I always do whenever I'm working on any picture is I make a copy of the background layer. Let's just go ahead and drag that down to the new layer button right there. Gives us a copy. That's just a safety. Just in case I mess this up somehow or other. We won't in this video, but just in case, I always do this. If I mess it up, I can always go back to my original copy right down there as the background layer. Okay, in here, we need to make a selection around this. We'll do the outside first, and we'll use that to create our layer mask. We'll then come in and we'll do the inside sections, and then delete those from the layer mask. We'll clean those up in the layer mask as well. Now to get this just the right size, I'll use the zoom tool over here, and if you hold the mouse button down, you can kind of go back and forth like this. It's called scrubbing. And Scrubby Zoom is one of your options up here. So you go left and right, you can zoom in or zoom out. Real nice, easy way to get exactly the right size that you want. I'll just pull it over here a bit to the left. So working large helps us obviously on this one. Now you may want to come in real tight on this as you're putting in your points for your path. Just make sure you're perfectly accurate. I'm not going to spend that much time on this. You'll see the technique. And then if you want to take a little bit more care on that, that's of course perfectly acceptable and really the way to go. We'll start off with the pen tool over here. There's the pen tool. And what I normally do is I just put in straight points first. I then convert those points to curves as a second pass around. I just find it a bit easier to think it that way. Now, this is a corner. We're going to leave this as a straight point anyway. So right in that corner, put your first point right there. And then this is all one curve over to about here. It kind of blends into the next curve, which is this curve here on the side. It kind of blends in right there. Hard to see where that happens. But there's kind of a corner point right there. So I like to choose a point between here and here. So I'll come right over here somewhere and get right on the edge of that ring right there. And in some place right over here. And right in here, there's another change. So I'll put a point right there. And then about halfway around this curve here, there's a point right there, so I'll put a point about halfway around the curve. There we go. You can always add in points or take out points in the future if these aren't exactly right. Okay, we have kind of a change here in direction to see that. So halfway between that and this, I'll put a point right there, and then right down here for that change of direction, and then right around here, that's actually one curve, and it kind of blends into a second curve down there. So I'll put a point right down here. Now it's a bit tricky right here because there's this shadow under there. So you want to come right up against that, right against the gold part. In between here and here, that's a bit of a curve. So I'll put one right in the middle of that as well. And then come back to your starting point. There we go. That's the basic points. Let's now convert the ones we want converted. Now, of course, I could click and drag as I put these in. Click and drag, and those give me curve points. I just like doing this as separate steps. So there we go. On this one, click and drag. Now sometimes this will come in upside down. You just flip it around like that. We'll see if that happens on any of these. Bring it out so it's about right. Don't worry about this yet. Right now we're just getting the basic positions in here and our basic curves down. And just work around. Now this one is a corner, so I don't want that to be a curve. Leave that as a corner. Okay, come down over here. Didn't quite get the point on that one. There we go. So that one came in upside down, so just pull it out this way. Again, don't worry if the curves aren't perfect yet at this point. That doesn't really matter. We're going to be adjusting that as we go. And then our last one right down here. Okay, so there's our basic curves, and we're just about there already, as you can see. Although we have a bad spot right there. We'll fix that with this piece over here. Now, with this particular tool here, it's kind of interactive. You can actually come here and grab these endpoints without changing away from that change style tool that we're just using there, and actually pull these points out. Now I can't click on this one because this will change that to the other kind of point. So I'll switch over here to the direct selection tool right there. That way I don't mess anything up accidentally. Now if you're using this tool and just grab the control point, notice how it moves both of those control points. And most of the time that's the way you want it to behave. But in here we actually have a different curve. So if I move this one in to get that fixed, it's moving this one out. You solve that by holding down the Alt key when you click on that other point. I can then move this one independently. So it allows you to get both of those curves exactly right. Make sure that you don't get any real corners happening in there. You'll be careful about that. Okay, just work your way around and take your time to do a nice clean curve. Looks pretty good right now. I could go in a lot tighter and do real careful, absolutely perfect on this, but I'm not going to take that much time here in this video. I'm just going to open this up just a little bit. Right there. Okay, that curve looks good. That curve looks good. It'll look good down here. Maybe I can move this one over just a little bit. And that can come in just a touch. And just a little bit more on that one curve right there. Okay, so there's the outside. Now, still using the direct selection tool, right click on that path and choose Make Selection. I have mine set here for a 1 pixel feather radius. Choose OK. And there's that nice selection around there. Let's just click on this little button right down here. This is your layer mask, and that makes a layer mask out of that selection. There we go. Outside is done. Now we have these inside parts. You'll see these are all triangle shapes. That's a triangle, that's a triangle. This is kind of a weird bent triangle, but they're all basically triangle shapes. When I have a triangle shape with curves, what I like to do is to use 6 points. I'll do a point in the corner, right there, and then a point halfway across the side, a point in the corner, a point halfway down the side, a point in the corner, and halfway down the side, and of course back to the beginning again. And I'll switch back over here to the Convert Point tool, and I'll convert the ones that are in the middle of the sides, convert these into curves. So there's that one. That one flipped. There we go. That one, that's pretty close right there already. And that one's flipped. Just fix that flip. That looks pretty good. Okay, it's a little bit off right here, so I'll switch back over to the direct selection tool, and I'll pull this one out a bit, and that should give me that last curve. There we go. Now again, it's not absolutely perfect in here, as you can see, but you know, for this video, this is fine. I take a little bit longer being absolutely perfect if this is an actual working project. Okay, now that I have that done, just right-click on that path, and then Make Selection. There it is. Same thing. Choose OK. Now it's a selection, and we're on top of the layer mask over here. So all we have to do is just fill this with black. So there's your black foreground color. Grab your paint bucket, click and fill. There we go. And then deselect. Okay, same trick for the other two triangles, and that's all there is to it. And these are pretty small, so I'm going to zoom in here. I'll use the Scrubby zoom again. And if you hold the space bar down, you can move things around. There we go. I think we can now get both of those pretty easily. Same trick. Click in the corner, click halfway down the side, click in the corner, halfway, corner, halfway and corner. This one almost doesn't need it because those are almost straight lines, but we'll put just a little bit of curve on those. And again, grab that and pull it out and make it a curve. Same thing here. Now it was flipped. There we go. And that was flipped as well. Okay, pull them out and then just a little, oh, maybe just undo that. Forgot to change my tool. There we go. So I'm going to move this over just a little bit down to this edge. Now when it's selected like this, you actually can use your cursor keys in here to move things around as well. I just had that selected, just a little bit of a move right there using the cursor key. And bring that down just a touch. And then with the control handles, and this one again, just the cursor keys, the arrow keys, up just one click. It's a real subtle curve in there. Okay, right click, and again, make selection. That all stays the same. Let's fill that one. There we go. And deselect, or the Control-D keyboard shortcut on that. And your pen tool. Last triangle in here, same exact thing. Right into the corner, halfway down the side, into the corner, halfway down the side, into the corner, halfway down the side, and then back into the corner again. Go back to our Convert tool. Click and pull that out a little ways. That gives us that curve. Same thing here. Click and pull it out. Just gives us our curve. And click and pull that one out, and that gives us our last curve right in there. And that one looks pretty good. And then back to our Direct Selection tool. Right click. Make selection. Okay. Fill with black. And let's deselect that. And there we go. Okay. Let's just go to fill screen. And there it is. We've cleaned out that background. Now all we need to do is just put a white layer behind this. Come down to the background layer. Add a new layer right there. Let's fill that with white. There it is. And there's your cleaned up background. See how that looks? There it is before. It's like we moved it a little bit as we're working here. That's okay. I'll use my cursor keys to just get this back into position again. There it is. Okay. With background and cleanup without the background. And the pen tool, as you saw, is a great way to do this. It just needs to be done in steps. Do the outside first, and then do each of your inside sections. And there you go. The nice thing about the pen tool is I can always go back and clean things up on my layer mask if I want to. There's like a little bit of a corner right down here. It's not just absolutely perfect. Let's go ahead and fix that. I'll zoom in on that spot. Just a little bit. It's very, very subtle, but just a little bit right there. You can do that again with the pen tool. Just come over here a bit. Come over to this side a little ways. And then out and around like that. And then let's convert this point to a curve, and this one to a curve, and then just rematch the curve in there. There we go, nice little curve. Same exact thing, right click on this, make selection. Don't go in and fill the whole thing. All you have to do here is just paint that little bit black, since black hides. So you're a paintbrush, and then right along that edge. There it is. Deselect, and let's go back to fit on screen. So there you go. That's how to remove the background or convert your background to a nice clean white using the pen tool. There's the original, and there's the cleaned up background. Don't forget to click that like button and, of course, share by clicking the share button as well. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop right down there in the description. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.